Order Rambler here again, and once again I've managed to get another night out. I've just finished work this afternoon, 2 o'clock. Don't go back in until Thursday, so thought I would head out tonight. Sort of looking for a dry forecast. It's cold, bit of snow lying about where we're going, but yeah, it should be a dry one, which is the main thing. But 2:30 now, so I need to get cracked on. Get my gears put together, and I'll catch you later on now. Cheers, out for now.
Sky now. So it's starting to drop, so is the bloody temperature. Scanning the tent. Put the sling bag down and the mat underneath. And the sheet under the tent. Sunset. It's a criffle.
just popped out through the clouds. Some lovely glows now. It's not a bad sky now. The final rays. Well, a bit squashed in tonight. It's warm enough though, which is the main thing. Right, that's us in the tent for now. Bit of a wind getting up, so gonna be a bit breezy tonight. Doesn't know if we're not shut these, does it? Right, not very much different. Yeah. Anyhow, got a couple of drinks for later. Out for now. Thatcher's leaf twister. Some cider for the change. Got a couple of cans. But, all I'm having, it's cold, I'll be spend all night peeing. Well, I'll give these a try and see what they taste like. Right, it's not bad stuff this. It's just got me talking with a funny voice though. Roar. You think I was on top of a hill or something? Morning. Half five. That was a cold one last night. That wind just... It wasn't really strong, but it was just there all the time. It just kept the chill. So I want to... get a brew on and get some porridge into us. Try and warm up a bit. But yeah, it's definitely... What temperature is it in here? Bloody cold is what it is. Zero degrees. That'll be why then. A bit Baltic. Right, I'll get a brew one. Good morning, guys.
across an old shieling here. Probably an old farm cottage or something. Long time not used though. It's the white line running off the hills, the source is top of the fells up here. Comes all the way into the Esk and then out into the Solway, Lost Band there. This is the so-called footpath up to Christianby Crags. Yeah, there's your way marker. And there's a rake of fallen trees blocking the path all the way up. So yeah, they're obviously not looking after this path anymore. Right, I've got to try and get across this river somehow, stream. It's not the shallowest of places to cross, but look for the narrowest. And just go for it. Go for it, go for it! It is a cross in the fashion. Yeah, sort of wet feet, but with the gaiters on, it's not too bad. Yeah, banks are washing away there. It used to be sort of a decent defined path along the stream till they cut the trees down, and obviously since the trees have gone, everything's just grown, and it's a bit of a nightmare trying to trace the footpath, because believe it or not, this is a footpath. You wouldn't think so in parts. It's just completely blocked, fallen trees and stuff growing. Here we go, another obstacle. Obstacles. It's a battle. It's all this stuff they locked down and done out with it. They're not interested. Look at it all. Shit everywhere. Where they've just lopped it off and left it and then replanted. Maybe get some of their asses back down here and tidy it all up. But I know that'll never happen. In the old rant over. yes, you can't see in the camera, but there's a little fence there, and there's a dipper sat on the fence. Get quite a few of them on this stretch of the right line. It's just waiting for me to disappear. Yeah, this is the final bit of the walk. That's the probably the nastiest bit. It used to be alright, as I say, till they ruined the path, and now it's like an obstacle course and it's all uphill. But nearly at the car. See you soon. As you can see, not the best. Getting there, slowly. Yeah, it's a long burner. Fairly blitzing the forest now. Well, that's that done for today. 10 to 10. The plan. I suppose it was from half past five, right? And took a few photos. Had some breakfast, tidy up, and have a bit more around the forest, taking a few more photographs. But, yeah, a couple of lessons learned. Still carrying too much gear. Still feels too heavy. I don't know what the hell I've got in this bag. I thought I'd weighed everything, and but there's always some extra you seem to bring along that you don't need. And the sleeping bag. I used the cheap one last time, which was heavier, but it's warmer. And I've got this other one, Mountain Warehouse. It wasn't up to much. It's too light. I mean, it is really great because it's lightweight, fits in the bag. Really compact, you know. But there wasn't a lot of warmth with it. Even my feet were nice and warm, just my body felt cold. And I know I was right in a sort of drafty place, so that it was blowing in under the tent because I wasn't on totally flat ground, it was getting underneath. So that was probably making it a lot colder as well. So obviously from my last camp I was quite sheltered. Bit of rock. Sort of wind as such, so I mean it was cold the last time, but didn't feel as cold, but this time did. Anyhow, you learn, it all went well, I survived, as they say, and that's that one. Until the next time, board a Rambler, out for now.